What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode. I'm Nick, and today we're doing something a little bit different. We're at Bullard's Bar today, which is a beautiful lake. So today is like a trial business run for me. I'm super excited to announce that Ensei and I are starting our own kayak guide service. So starting February 1st, we're going to start taking people out, going on sturgeon trips, teaching you how to go for crab in Half Moon Bay or Pacifica, rainbow trout in fresh water, or you want to go sturgeon fishing or steelhead fishing. So if you're interested to do things like this, like outdoor chef life, diehard fishing, come out here, do it once or twice with us, and then you'll be able to do it yourself. So today I want to show you guys what it would be like to go on a kokanee trip with us. Maybe we'll catch a fish or two and maybe learn a thing or two. So wish us luck. Oh yeah, and that reminds me, guys, if you haven't entered our 5K giveaway, we're about 20 people away. So this is your last chance. We're giving away a free guided fishing trip in San Diego. Check out my San Diego trip video for more information.
My ears are so cold. All right, here you go. This is a 4-pound test, so.
So you want me to have a heartbreak today?
No, just keep your drag kind of loose. So this is just like a homemade hoochie rig. Double hooks here, size 6 double hooks. And then you put a bobber stop so your hoochie doesn't go all the way down into the hooks.
Mm-hmm.
You want to keep the hoochie, the hooks right below the hoochie there. And then I just added a little spinning blade here. Gonna attract the kokanee, and then you're gonna put your your corn onto the hooks here.
Okay.
But that's about it, man. That goes behind your flasher. Try it out, man. Then let me get you some corn here. We could probably do it on the water.
The canoe.
What's that?
The canoe.
Yeah.
And the beast. The beast. But this canoe life is pretty cool.
Yeah, I've been doing it since I was a little kid. Started out when I was 8 years old.
Oh my god, all my kayak has ice over it. Everything has ice on it. So you guys, look at my fish finder. Frozen over. Look at that ice. Crazy. It's cold, guys. My toes are feeling it. It's so cold, my fish finder's not working. There it is. All right, guys, welcome to Bullard's Bar. Let's do this. Oh, my toes. My toes, they hurt. They're so cold. But it's beautiful out here. So, if you guys have never gone trout fishing on a kayak or never came to Bullard's Bar before, we're gonna be doing a trip here. So you can do this too if you want to, starting in February. Okay, I won't mess around. I want to get 10 today. What?
A beleza que não é só minha, que
poquito pasó sozinha. Se ela soubesse que quando ela passa, o mundo sorrindo se enche de graça e fica mais lindo por causa do amor.
Oh, my toes. All right, guys. Ensei just got his first one.
Yes, he would give his heart gladly. But it's day when she walks to the sea. She looks...
Anyways, we're arriving to the fishing spot right now. I have a downrigger on my right side and a deep diver on my left side. I'm using the Shasta Tackle sling blades on both sides, the small UV one. And on one side I have a wiggle hoochie, and on the other side I have a hoochie with a little spinner blade on it. So this is the first time I've used a downrigger on my channel, or at least on this kayak. So I want to show you my setup real quick. The Hobie AI comes with these rails, which makes it really convenient to put mounts on it. The mount for my downrigger is a Scotty mount. And the mounts for my camera holder and my rod holders are Railblazer. So right now I'm kind of working my way into the sun a little bit more. It's colder than usual today. Water temperature is 49 degrees. So the fish are going to be up near the surface. They're going to be shallow towards the banks. And today, because it's so cold and the sun is still coming up a little bit, I think they're going to be kind of in the sun, partially in the shade where they can go back and forth. But I think I'll have some more luck if I go more towards the sun where the water is a little more warmed up. So I'm not sure if that's correct or not. Some people say that when the sun comes out, it actually slows down the kokanee bite. They say that they go deeper into the water. But the lake that I'm at today is pretty deep, 150 feet. So the water temperature doesn't change too much. But I definitely agree, the kokanee bite is in the morning. And as the sun comes up and the day starts heating up, the bite starts to die down. Oh yeah, fish just jumped right there. Show. It pulled the downrigger too. Yeah, these guys fight good for a little guys. Trying to remember where I am so I can come back over this spot, but I'm also trying to pull him out of there so he doesn't spook his friends. Oh yeah, they're all right here, guys. he came off. I messed around too much, guys. I was messing around too much, guys. Damn it. All right, now I'm angry. Now I'm gonna get him. Let's go. Now I'm excited, boys. So I'm gonna clip. This and the downrigger are pretty tight because that guy pulled it all the way off the downrigger. You just take one single piece of corn, put it on each hook. So if you put more than one, it's gonna affect the action of the lure. Now I'm gonna put it 15, 20, 30 feet behind my bow. Then I kind of point my rod tip towards the front of the boat and see how the line comes to me. Put my rod in the rod holder. Get this line. Take the line, clip it deep into the downrigger. The reason you put it so deep in your downrigger is kokanees, they do short strikes a lot. So if it just pops out of the downrigger real easily, they don't get a good hook set in the mouth. Reel it down to bend that rod a little bit so that it springs up. And now we're gonna just go over the same spot we just went over. Oh, fish on. Pull it off the downrigger. Come on. Stay on here, buddy. Stay on here, buddy. Oh, did I lose him again? I think I lost him again. Oh no, he's still there. Just swimming with me. Come on, Kokanee, get in here. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Small guy. Look at how beautiful though, guys. Tiny. Look at how pretty though. It has rainbow trout on the top. So shiny. Tiny. That's like a pan fryer right there. Why can't I get this hook out? Woohoo! No skunk. I drove all the way to Lake Tahoe for that little guy. They smell good. It's weird. These kokanee, they smell like an ocean fish. Really nice smell. It smells like fresh anchovies. If you guys have ever smelled that before. First kokanee ever, boys. Woohoo! First kokanee ever. All right, guys, so if you want a cheap, ultralight rod, the Okumo Celilo, it's a great option. God damn it, it came off. I've caught a lot of trout and now kokanee on this, and man, the fight is so good. When you scale down your gear like that, it seriously feels like a big fish. Thank you.
Fish on.
I think. Small guy, maybe?
Yeah, small guy, I think.
Is this number two? There she blows. Get in here. Get in here. Yeah, boy. Get in here, boy. Kokanee. Oh, so pretty. Mini chrome. Yeah. Baby chrome! Baby chrome! So on that one, I put the line really deep in the clip so that it was hard to pop off. That kokanee couldn't even pop it off the downrigger, so I had to manually pop it off. But sometimes that's good because it really sets the hook on the fish. Sometimes when the downrigger pops off at the same time they bite the hook, it kind of gives them a little cushion and it doesn't set the hook very well. You know what I forgot to do, guys? And this is a good test. I forgot to put corn on the end of the hooks. Let's see if they bite without the corn. I'm trolling behind Ensei, and Ensei just caught one right in front of me. So I'm gonna go right behind him and try to hit the same school that he hit. Oh, I'm bit. Yeah.
Lucky hookie!
I don't know if it's still on though. I think it, oh yeah, it's still on. So is this fish.
This fishing, guys, is so much fun. So much action. You learn a lot, and it's very similar to fishing ocean salmon. So if you guys are new to ocean salmon, never caught a salmon before, and you want to practice, fishing for rainbow trout and kokanee during the winter time are great ways to practice. They fight very similar to salmon. So getting them on the boat, getting them in the net, keeping them on the hook, it's one of the more challenging fish, in my opinion.
Oh yeah, I'm on. I'm on. Oh, this is a good one. Uh-oh, this is not a kokanee. This is catfish. Oh no!
Oh, he's still on there. Woo, this is a good one. Fighting good. Yeah, it's got some weight to it. This might be my biggest kokanee. PB kokanee.
Yeah, this one's got better size to it.
Oh yeah. In the boat. Beautiful. Oh, these fish smell so good. If you guys are interested in doing a trip like this, let me know in the comments below. We just reached 5,000 subscribers. Thank you guys so much. Yeah, guys, this is definitely becoming one of my favorite fishing. You know, they don't get very big. You're not looking for that trophy fish, but it's kind of fun just to catch something, you know? Something with the fight, something that fights like salmon a little bit. And when you scale down all this gear, it's freaking fun. Dude, look at the marks on the freaking, oh my gosh, guys. So many fish. And we got it all to ourselves. Like, there's nobody on the lake, the whole entire lake. We have the whole place to ourselves. Like, how often do you find a big group of fish like this and it just doesn't get molested? Yeah, what a day, man. I've never caught 10 trout salmon before. That's more salmon than I've caught all year. Oh, dude, this is badass, dude. A little lower.
Nice.
I got a bunch of them, so.
Limits, boys!
Let's go home! Check us out at NorCal Kayak Adventures.
You!